If you guys are looking for super cheap, fast, and reliable Madden 21 coins, look no further than my sponsor, MuttReserve.com. Coins are currently discounted, guys. They got 24/7 support. They're super awesome to work with. Head on over, use code Poodle for an additional 15% off your order. What's going on, everybody? It's Poodle back with another Madden Ultimate Team video, guys. And today, we got plenty of stuff to go over. We have new LTDs. Series 2 is coming tomorrow morning, guys. And today, we're going to be going over some stuff before Series 2. We got some screenshots of Series 2, so I will be showing you that. He showed us some new players. We got a bunch of stuff coming out, guys. I'm super excited to go through all of it. Now, tomorrow, that means we're going to have a new max mutt level, new sets, new solos, maybe a gauntlet, maybe a journey. We're going to have plenty of stuff, guys. I'm super excited. New team affinities or team diamonds, whatever those things were. Plenty of stuff. We got today's LTDs. I'm super excited, guys. It is a great, great day to be making some Madden, to be playing some Madden, to do everything Madden related. I'm super hyped that we got all this back again, guys. Been a while since we had some like stuff to be doing on a daily basis. Now, guys, for today's Poodle Squad shout-out, we're going to go to A-Train209. Thank you so much, A-Train, for being a part of the family. Thank you for being a part of the Poodle Squad. If you guys want a chance to be shout-out in the next Poodle Squad, all you got to do is go down below, like the video, turn the noty bell next to the sub button, and comment down below Poodle Squad, and, of course, be subscribed, guys. Thank you so much for showing support each and every day. Let's get into this. So, first, guys, we got Series 2 coming tomorrow, probably around 10:30-ish, the usual time. A lot of new stuff. I'm going to make a video over today, going over today, what you want to be doing before Series 2, so make sure to be checking that out, because of course there's plenty of stuff to be doing. We have new LTDs in the game. We'll see if they're on the block. If they're not, I'm going to show you guys the screenshots of them. So we got Dalvin Cook and Kawan Short today. Let's go check those guys out, address some title update stuff, and then get into Series 2 and all the other stuff that pertains to that. Alright, guys, so first thing in today's title update, we have fixed the gameplay physics issue, sometimes preventing receivers from properly catching the ball, which was exposed by a work in Tuesday's title update. So guys, for all you guys who know about the glitch, where pretty much when you throw it to an open receiver and the receiver just drops the ball or can't seem to hold on to it, even when they're the most wide open you've ever seen, that is being addressed in today's title update, which is super huge because Weekend League does come out today at around 4:30 p.m. Eastern time. So for all you guys who want to compete on Weekend League, including myself, it was going to be super frustrating to play and potentially lose out on opportunities because of dropped catches. So that's super important. Props to EA for getting that fixed as soon as possible. I mean, obviously, they shouldn't have had broken that in the first place, but I'm glad they did address it as soon as they did, because that shows that they do somewhat care and they want to get this fixed for Weekend League, which is good because we're going to be competing and that's where a lot of our money, you know, a lot of reasons why you buy a team is for that reason. Now, moving on, guys, we have Kawan Short as the first LTD for the Carolina Panthers, defensive tackle 90 overall. Again, these are our Thursday LTDs. They kind of replace Signature Series. He's got 67 speed, 82 excel, 88 strength, 88 tackle, 89 play rec, 92 blocks, 88 power movement. He's a really, really good defensive tackle. Hemmed up and powered up, he will get the power move threshold, the play rec threshold, the tackle threshold, and he'll have a block shed above like a 90, probably like a 93, 94 block shed, depending on the way your team comes to set up. He's going to be insane. He's going to be one of the top tier pass rushers and block shedders. Now, his speed will be really low, but he's a defensive tackle. So, as long as you're a defensive tackle, I guess for the most part, we can overlook the speed, although some people prefer just to play without defensive tackles. Really up to you, but Kawan Short's pretty good, not gonna lie. His price point, I'm looking right now, I don't see anything going up for him yet, so I can't really know where his price is gonna be at. Dalvin Cook is up though, 1.8 million. He's gonna be crazy, but let's go to Dalvin Cook. 90 overall halfback for the Minnesota Vikings. 89 speed, 90 excel, 91 agility, 86 carry, 64 catching, 92 change of direction, 72 truck, and 86 break tackle. And Dalvin Cook is really good. The only thing is that we do a Barry and Bo, so he's going to overshadow a lot of running backs. Just like last year when we had Marcus Allen and a few other guys, it overshadowed a lot of running backs. But Dalvin Cook is still great. Powered up and chemmed up, we're going to get him to a 90 speed, which is good. 91 excel, 92 agility, and he's going to have an 87 carry. Now, when you have your chems and everything on him, he will get some stuff up, some agility potentially with sprinter, some speed up, some carry up, some break tackle. Change of direction is really solid. It'll be a 93 after being powered up. He's a really good running back. He's really great. It's just because he's an LTD, he may be limited by the amount of people that can actually use him. See, if he was a regular style card, the one for maybe like 180K to 200K, you could be like, okay, half the price of Bo Jackson, very similar, I can pick him up. But if he's going to be an LTD that costs just as much as Barry Sanders or somewhere between Barry and Bo, you might just opt for Bo. Although I would prefer Dalvin over Bo, but stats-wise, I think you still got to rock with Bo because Bo is the trucking, Bo has the speed, Bo is everything. Bo essentially has everything that Dalvin doesn't have, or everything Dalvin has, but better. So you really can't dip out on Bo. Just yet. Now, again, Dalvin's probably going to be like in the 600K range when all said and done, 600K, versus being below him now. Again, like I said, if he was a regular style kickoff card or something, would have been a whole nother story, but that is not the case, sadly. Now, let's get into some of the Series 2 stuff. So here you go. This is the Series 2 exchange. Trade in three elite 85s, 86 overalls for a random elite player. Now, this is great. You know why? Because we do have all those free players from Jom. Mud Epics. We have the Epics players like the Ronnie Lott, the Jack Youngblood and all them. So if you have those cards now in your team, you can now exchange them for an 87 to 88 overall. So you can essentially turn a bunch of bum players that you maybe don't use anymore into really, really great players. So I will make a video on that tomorrow going over all that stuff. But guys, that is a great option, and I highly recommend you go ahead and get that done. Of course, we're gonna have a new max mutt level tomorrow, probably max mutt level 60. We're gonna have a new currency as well. We're gonna have a bunch of new stuff in the game that we didn't have prior, so definitely make sure to go ahead and take advantage of that. Get some stuff done today. The new exchange is big though, because it means we can get rid of a lot of nat players. A lot of players that you have nat from solos and stuff that you can't start in your team, trade them in, get an 87 to 88. Either go, you can go ahead and take that player and start them, or you can go and sell them on the block. More than likely, selling the block is the most viable way to get a return on your value there, more than likely. But again, it's always up to you. But moving on from that, guys, we do have more stuff seriously related. So we do get team standouts, I believe, or whatever they're called. Xavier McKinney. So this is actually a rookie premiere. So rookie premiere Xavier McKinney will have an 87 speed, 89 excel, 80 tackle, 81 play rec, 83 pursuit, 82 zone, 79 man, 84 hit power. Now, he's a decent safety, but again, if you have a rookie premiere version of him, you will be getting a pretty great player for free, essentially, that you already have. So it looks like they're going to be covering some, that's how they're going to cover rookie premieres this year, because last year they didn't really cover all of them until around Christmas. I guess this year they're being nicer and they're going to make sure a promo such as this does actually go ahead and get us some upgrades early in the year. We do have Tristan Wirfs, another one. Now, right tackle Wirfs is actually kind of huge because that's a really good right tackle right now. 88 strength, 81 awareness, 81 pass blocking, 80 pass block power, 84 pass block finesse, 83 run block, 81 run block power, and 85 run block finesse. So yeah, overall, Wirfs is really solid. 85 run block finesse is one of the strongest stats he has. I mean, he's not great, he's not amazing, but for a free right tackle, and it is an upgrade. Now, I do hate that they always kind of nerf anyone that has a premier upgrade. They make sure their stats aren't that great. Always super annoying, but again, at least we got some kind of upgrade. Then we got CeeDee Lamb, wide receiver for the Cowboys. Now, he has come on pretty strong to start the season. Has been a great, great receiving option for them in real life. 88 speed's actually really good. That's a very usable card. 84 jumping, 85 catching, 82 catch traffic, 85 spec, 81 short, 82 medium, and 81 deep route running. Now, this card's decent overall. Not going to be a bad fourth receiver option or just a guy that comes in when people are tired. Honestly, I don't think he's bad at all. Again, he has 87 agility, really good with the ball in his hands, 88 excel, 6'2", 198 pounds. A really solid card overall. Now, again, guys, that's just some of the ones we're going to be seeing tomorrow. I imagine we'll be seeing much more. They will be tweeting out, I believe, tonight all of the cards related to Series 2 drop. So hopefully I'll have a reveal video for you guys sometime tonight. At some point, hopefully, we'll try to get that out as soon as possible. But that is about it. That is about it for today's video. Hopefully you guys did enjoy. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you want a chance to be shouted out into the next video with Poodle Squad, go down below, like the video, turn on that noti bell next to the sub button, as well as comment down below and let me know what you guys want to see. If for our Series 2 tomorrow, we're going to have a bunch of subliminal videos you want to see. Comment down below Poodle Squad as well. Make sure you subscribe to the channel, guys. Get the momentum going. Super hyped to have Series 2 back. I'm super excited to see that. Hopefully, guys, it's a banger tomorrow. Guys, that's about it for the video. Enjoy the rest of your day. I'm out. Peace.